how much energy can be stored in a capacitor? How the different characteristic of capacitor are related to energy? The first thing, how do we store energy in capacitor? Answer, by giving it charge. The process is, this is plate of capacitor. I give it charge plus. When I want to give it next positive charge, this plus will repel. So I have to apply a force, do the displacement and do the work. Similarly, this force will go on increasing when the charges are increasing, and finally I have to do a lot of work to keep them here. Okay, so this plate, of course, with induction, there will be negative here. By giving the charge, the potential rise to V and the charge store here is Q. Now, how do I calculate work done? The answer is, in electricity, whenever you have to calculate work done, you have to do it with potential. Because potential, initially we made this concept of potential by the formula work done on a unit charge. Work upon charge. Okay, and this work is what? Force into displacement. Force into displacement. Charge. Okay, so this is potential related to work. So work is equal to what? Potential into charge. These are the different formulas, mechanics, we all know. So here, work W is equal to Q into V. But the thing is that when we started working, the potential was zero. When we put certain charge, potential increased. Again, we put certain charge, potential increased. So finally, it has come to this value. So initially, how much work we did? Initially, we had to do work when we were putting first charge. We had to do work zero. Finally, when I put the last of this charge Q, the potential had gone to V. How much work I had to do? Final. Q into V. This is initial, this is final. So, what is the average work done? Work average. This is 0 plus QV upon 2. This is half QV. This is the average work done for the full value of V. So this value of V, which was 0 initially, increase, increase, increase. Every time I was doing W2, W3, W4, W, and final W was Q into V. This is the final V. So, initial work done 0, final work done Q, and what will be the average work done? That will be half Q into V. This is energy. Okay. This appears to be a very simple method. So, some teachers don't agree. They say, let's complicate it. So, how do we complicate it? Suppose I give it a very small, I give it a charge Q. With that, there is a small change in V, dV. Then, the work done is Q into dV. Charge Q is given. Potential increase by dV. Then, what is this small work? dW is equal to Q into dV. And now, what is the total work done when we increase the voltage from 0 to V? Then this will be integration of Q dV. For each small dV, if I have increased V is equal to 0 2. This height, which is V, is equal to V. So this I have divided into dV, 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 dV. I give the charge Q, raise potential dV. How much work is done? Q into dV, Q into dV, Q into dV. And the total work from this to this is integration Q into dV. And this integration I will do from V is equal to 0 to V is equal to V. So this is mathematical method. Now this Q, we know by the formula Q is equal to C into V. C is equal to Q upon V. From this we get Q is equal to CV. So I put it as 0 to V C V dV. Okay. Now C is capacitance, which depends upon epsilon naught A upon D. During this charging process, neither K change, nor epsilon change, nor A change, nor D is changing. So this remain a constant. C remain a constant, it will come out. Integration of V dV is V square upon 2. So this is half C V square. This is work done, and this work done converts to energy. So energy is half CV square. We did energy is equal to half QV. So these two formulas, and Q is equal to what? C into V. Put it here. What it will be? Half CV square. Here one C and one V, make it Q. So that will be Q into V. So both are same formulas. We can even convert it into a third formula. This is C into V, this is Q into V, and one we can have Q and C. How? This V is equal to, this V is equal to Q upon C. Put it Q upon C here. So this will be U is equal to half Q square upon C. This is third formula. So this is one form, this is other form, this is third form. These are the three formulas for energy given to a capacitor. Most of the time we are using this formula because C is a measurable quantity, V is a measurable quantity. Q and Q, these are not measurable quantities. So this is more acceptable and measurable formula. U is equal to half CV square energy. Remember, in mechanics, our formula for energy is half mv square. This is a constant known as inertia. This is a constant known as inertia. V is velocity, which increase, energy increase. V is voltage, which increase, energy increase. So there is an analogy between the two, and there will be so many quantities coming on the same formula, half. Okay, so this is capacity, as this is energy in a capacitor. Sometimes it is asked, where does this energy lie? So remember, this energy lie in the electric field between the two plates. Here, this is electric field, and the energy lies in this location. If there is a dielectric here, then we will say energy lies in the dielectric. So energy lie in the electric field or in the dielectric, and this is the energy on capacitor. Now in the next topic we will study that if we want to increase capacitance, decrease capacitance, can we join two capacitors? If we join two capacitors, how we should join them so that we get larger capacitance, so that we get larger charge, so that we get larger potential. How do we join them, and what is effect after joining, and how are the methods of joining? So that we will do in the next lecture.